have the presentations in here or do it in the field. I think there is the real issue, though, that we've had a hard enough time maintaining civility in this room, much less a site visit, which is a real challenge for us. And so if we were to do site visits, how would the district ensure that the members of the public that attended maintain the Brown Act, Robert's Rules? It's not a two-way conversation. When I do these types of park commission meetings for my day job, that's the first, and I did one about 6 weeks ago in on-site, it's the first thing that's announced to the public. We had like 10 members of the public come, but the first thing that's announced is, this is not an opportunity for two-way conversation between the public and commissioners or staff. And that was respected. I don't feel like we have that luxury here. So if we, again, I guess I'll throw it back on the district, if we are to do those, how would the district maintain that level of stability? So those are my thoughts on that.
And I don't think that the attempting to practice civility has proven to work yet by any stretch. So I don't have an answer for that.
No, well, that's
and I don't know that that can be solved, to be entirely honest with you, outside of, okay, do we want to go the route of bringing in sheriff deputies and having people...
It's expensive.
It is, and having people physically removed from meetings. I would like to personally try to avoid that, but I will also say when we had sheriff deputies at the board meetings, they were some of the more efficient board meetings we had.
Well, this idea was born out of that context of maintaining civility. When I watched the meeting at the board, that really wasn't talked about at all.